The first four caliphs of the Islamic Empire, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Ali, are referred to as Rashidun Caliphs by mainstream Sunni Muslims. Their tenure started with the death of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in 632 CE, when Abu Bakr took the title of Caliph, the successor of the Prophet, although not a continuation of prophethood itself, and ended with the assassination of Caliph Ali in 661 CE. During their reign, the armies of Islam united the Arabian Peninsula under the banner of their faith, and then conquered parts of the Byzantine Empire and the whole of the Sasanian Empire. These swift and permanent conquests were halted during the reign of the last of these Rashidun Caliphs, Ali, who spent most of his reign in civil war, and whom Shia Muslims consider the only legitimate heir to Muhammad, peace be upon him. The Rashidun Caliphs introduced an innovative administrative system, and although they failed to gain supreme authority, their system would be carried on and molded to suit the needs of time by subsequent rulers up to 1924 CE. Caliph Abu Bakr. The death of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in 632 CE, was a tragic loss for his followers. Many even refused to accept that he was gone. Since Muhammad, peace be upon him, had claimed to have received divine revelations, his followers were now worried that they would no longer be guided by the divine force. More practical issues also surfaced since Muhammad, peace be upon him, had not appointed an heir to his position, nor did he have a natural heir of his own. Soon after Muhammad's death, many of the Arabian tribes declared that their pact with Muhammad was of personal nature and that they felt no obligation towards Islam. To make matters worse, many other people had started claiming the title of Prophet. However, during his lifetime, Muhammad had made it very clear to his followers that he was the last prophet of God, and so these people were impostors in the eyes of the Muslims. Abu Bakr, a close confidant of Muhammad, peace be upon him, and the first male convert, rallied the support of the majority of the Muslim Ummah and took the title of Khalifa, meaning successor of the Prophet. His claim was not uncontested, as a group of Muslims called Shi'arit Ali pushed for Ali as the only legitimate candidate for the caliphate, but Abu Bakr's authority prevailed. The apostates and false prophets posed an imminent threat to the very existence of Islam. Most notable and the strongest of them was Musaylimah, the arch liar, as he is referred to by the Muslims. The Arabian Peninsula had fragmented once again, and if these parties were to join hands against a common enemy, Medina and Mecca, the Empire of Islam would have been crushed in its cradle. Abu Bakr showed his ability as a natural leader. He called all able-bodied faithful men to arms for jihad. He knew that though his enemies were numerically superior, they were disunited, and he used this opportunity to its fullest. He divided the Muslim army into multiple corps and sent each to subjugate a particular part of the Arabian Peninsula. These wars became known as the Ridge Wars. The most notable general of these wars was Khalid ibn al-Walid, who defeated Musaylimah's forces, despite being heavily outnumbered, in the Battle of Yamamah, where Musaylimah was killed as well. By the end of the Ridge Wars, the whole of the Arabian Peninsula was united under the banner of Islam, and for this, Abu Bakr is referred to as the second founder of Islam. Knowing that Arabs lived by the rule of retribution and that the tribes that were subjugated by force would want revenge, Abu Bakr decided to direct their energies elsewhere. He knew exactly where to go next: the neighboring lands of Syria and Iraq, which were under Byzantine and Sasanian rule respectively. since both of these empires had exhausted themselves entirely with their constant warring, now was the perfect time to strike. He sent armies to both of these provinces to extend his dominion over the Arabian tribes inhabiting them. Khalid was sent to Iraq, where he was very successful. In the meanwhile, the campaigns in Syria were also bearing fruit. The Byzantine Emperor Heraclius realized that these attacks were not mere aids and prepared for an effective counterattack. Sensing this, Abu Bakr ordered Khalid to leave Iraq and move to Syria. Khalid then showed his military genius. He handpicked his best men and had some camels forcefully drink copious amounts of water. He then traveled all the way to Syria, through the barren, trackless, and waterless desert. He slaughtered one camel each day to quench the thirst of his men during their journey. When he entered Syria, he began raiding Byzantine territories and then used a joint Muslim force to defeat the Byzantines in the Battle of Ajnadayn, which further strengthened their position in the region. Abu Bakr did not live long enough to enjoy these successes though, for he died of natural causes soon afterwards.